This video will demonstrate how to construct a two-dimensional Mohr circle and find the stresses on an element of material. A two-dimensional graphical representation of an element can be drawn to show normal stress and shear stress. These stresses will help determine the principal stress and the maximum shear stress on a structural member. For example, this concrete column being stressed beyond its intended use shows that maximum stresses may be at an angle. This square represents a differential element rotated to the standard XY coordinate system. Here, the normal stresses are drawn in the positive sign convention. Positive normal stress is usually thought of as tension. This is the positive sign convention for shear stress on the XY plane. Notice the arrows are either head-to-head or tail-to-tail, never head-to-tail. Shown here is the complete positive sign convention for a differential element. The side or face of the element that the normal stress in the X direction acts on is referred to as the X face. This will be important later when looking at Mohr circle. Moving on, let's assume that this element is subjected to a normal stress in the X direction of negative 36 pounds per square inch. Remember that negative is compression, which is opposite of the positive sign convention. The normal stress in the y direction is equal to 50 pounds per square inch, and the shear stress on the xy plane is equal to 15 pounds per square inch. Both of these are positive because they are in the same direction as the positive sign convention. Notice that the stresses on the opposite sides of the element are equal and opposite in order to maintain equilibrium. From the element, we can begin calculations to draw Mohr circle. Step 1 is to compute the average normal stress, which is simply the average of the normal stresses in the x and y directions. The average normal stress here is equal to 7 psi. Step 2 is to calculate the radius, which is the square root of 1/2 of the difference between the stress on the x face and the stress on the y face squared plus the shear stress squared. The term inside of the parentheses is not the average normal stress. Step 3 is to draw Mohr circle. Begin by drawing the axes. The normal stress is the horizontal axis and the shear stress is the vertical axis. This example is solved by setting the shear stress to positive downward as shown, which is found in Hibbler's text and Gear's text. Beer and Johnson's text simply specifies positive shear upward, then reverses the shear sign when plotting the X face on Mohr circle. For the example shown here, the angle of rotation, or theta, will be positive in the counterclockwise direction. When drawing Mohr circle, begin by plotting the point for the average stress. We'll call it point C for the center of Mohr circle, which is equal to the average normal stress. The radius of the circle equals 45.5 pounds per square inch, so accurately draw the circle. Plot points X and Y on the graph. Point X is the point on the circle representing the stress conditions on the X face of the element when theta equals 0. Point Y is the point on the circle representing the stress conditions on the Y face of the element. Notice that the circle passes through both points. The last step is to solve for the principal stresses and the maximum shear stress. The maximum normal stress is equal to the average stress plus the radius, which equals 52.5 pounds per square inch and is located on the rightmost edge of the circle. The minimum normal stress is equal to the average stress minus the radius. This equals negative 38.5 pounds per square inch and is located on the leftmost edge of the circle. Finally, the maximum shear stress is equal to the radius. Having solved for all the stresses, let's take this problem one step further by applying it to the element. The axis on which the maximum and minimum normal stresses occur is referred to as the principal axis. The current position of the element is shown as the line XY on Mohr's circle, which is at an angle to the principal axis. The angle from the line XY to the principal axis is referred to as the principal angle. Reference the X face of the element and point X to determine the rotation of the element to its principal angle. It is important to remember that the angle shown on Mohr's circle is actually double the angle that the element is rotated. Also, angles are positive counterclockwise on Mohr's circle and positive counterclockwise on the element. Let's calculate 2 theta. Using the coordinates at point X and the radius of the circle as the right triangle, calculate theta. The element experiences the maximum normal stress when rotated -9.6 degrees. Notice that shear equals 0. You could calculate 2 theta using the tangent function and the right triangle, but be careful with the length of the sides. Return to the original element, and let's look at the principal angle in the opposite direction. This time, rotate counterclockwise, which is a positive angle. The new principal angle, theta, equals 80.4 degrees. The element also rotates positive, so that the X face on the element becomes sigma max. The Y face on the element becomes sigma min, and the shear stress equals 0. Compare the stresses on the element for the two principal angles. The orientation of the element and the stresses are exactly the same. But what if you wanted to know the angle of rotation to obtain the maximum shear stress? Well, the maximum shear is equal to the radius and occurs at the very top and very bottom of Mohr's circle. From the XY line, the angle to the maximum shear is positive on Mohr's circle because the rotation is counterclockwise. For the element to rotate in a positive direction, it also has to rotate counterclockwise. Calculate the angle theta. The shear stress on the element at the calculated angle is 45.5 pounds per square inch. The normal stresses on the X and Y faces equal the average normal stress at point C on Mohr's circle, which is 7 pounds per square inch. So this video looked at an element with normal and shear stresses given. Using Mohr's circle, the principal angle and the principal stresses were found and applied to the element. Then, the maximum shear angle and stresses were found and applied to the element. Watch this video again to remember how to draw Mohr's circle, calculate the maximum and minimum stresses, find the angles of rotation to the principal axis and the maximum shear, and how Mohr's circle relates back to the rotation of the element.